We don't ever like really answer a science question and ask a simpler one afterwards, right? Science gets more complicated and we ask more complicated questions and we want more advanced things, right? We want better medicine, we want better batteries for our phones, we want improvement, right? So in order to do that, you actually need a system today that's not only as capable as Aurora is in terms of computation, but it is as capable with AI as Aurora is. So I really hope the research community understands that this is not really just another iteration of a big system. So Aurora is starting this process with this incredible combination of simulation capability and learning capability. And with that, you're really shifting how you might ask your science questions. You're going to be asking questions and getting answers very quickly. Not necessarily in the scope of like, I ask a question 6 months later, I get an answer. You're going to be asking a question and maybe you're getting that answer in a day or a week. And that really changes the nature of the types of questions you can ask and the types of progress you can make in your research. Aurora is going to be able to deliver a lot of success stories. My interest, my priority, my excitement really comes in the types of success stories we will see come out of the science projects. The early science projects are covering a wide area of research. So we have projects that are looking at airplane design, right? So how can you design the wing or the tail rudder of an airplane to be more efficient, to generate less turbulence? It's going to increase your fuel efficiency and increase safety of planes, right? Projects looking at the fundamental nature of matter, right? Like, what are we made up of and why? Why is the universe the way it is? And really what's exciting out of that is that also informs why we are the way we are in many respects. This is adding aspects of physics into the way we study our universe and do simulations of it that have not been there before. But they're also doing that tightly coupled with what's coming out of observational facilities right now. And the kind of output from that can provide us with a huge amount of insight into like how the universe actually is structured and why it's structured. How can we find medicines to treat diseases more efficiently? Looking at designing a drug very quickly and effectively for disease treatment. And that is very exciting. We're also looking at things like mapping of the brain. So the brain is incredibly complicated. We don't really know what the structure of the brain is. And we've got a project that's looking at taking incredibly small nanometer scale slices and taking incredibly fine photographs of those at the APS across the lab and incorporating those to build a model on Aurora. So it really covers a broad range of types of science and approaches. Seeing what comes out of all of these projects and seeing what new things they're able to tackle and what new questions that come out of what they are going to do on Aurora, that's actually the most exciting thing for me because it's kind of the what's next and why this was important in the first place.